Men, gather round. I have a tale of glory and a tale of victory. Where a few strong men stood against the hordes of gynocentrism and feminism. And they fought until the very last man gave his last breath. Because this is living beast mode. And by beast mode law, we will all stand and fight and die to ensure that gynocentrism and feminism doesn't have us all walking around like eunuchs. Like in Game of Thrones, the Unsullied. Hey guys, OG Silverback here. Hey, I got a topic, man. Let me just tell you guys, man, like I think about a lot of things as I live my life and I go through my life doing what I do, man. Just seeing, being in society, just dealing with different situations I run across. So, there's this whole thing about toxic masculinity, dude. It's just like been really getting under my skin because it's part of the Me Too movement. So I had to make a video about it, man, because it's like it's getting out of hand, man. And I wanted you guys to really understand what's going on here and not get caught up in the media hype of the Me Too movement and fucking Terry Crews and fucking, he's a fucking mangina. I don't care how many muscles he's got, man. Dude's just cashing in on the Me Too movement and he's talking about this toxic masculinity. So how it all started, guys, is, you know, Terry Crews came out and saying he was sexually harassed in Hollywood, and then he was saying that, you know, it's because of the roles men play that men have to be accountable, and then this whole toxic masculinity came out. So then Gillette came out with this ad, dude. I'll be honest with you, man, and I'm showing you my sensitive side. I actually cried when I watched the fucking video clip. It's like a 1.5-minute video clip. I'll put it in the description, guys. It made me cry because the whole problem with this toxic masculinity, dude. Well, first of all, let me tell you what it means, man. So, just because I'm an information communication technology specialist, I'm a doctor of computers, I'm a scientist, dude. I'm an engineer. I have a very logical brain. So I want to understand, you know, and my dad taught me this when I was a kid. He said, like, if you don't know what a word means, write it down so you can look it up because it'll change the whole context of a conversation. So if a person's saying to you, hey, when you go across the Golden Gate Bridge, don't cross it because the bridge is out. But if you don't understand what don't means, right? And that's a simplistic term. I'm just trying to help you guys get wrap your head around this. Then you're going to proceed over because you're thinking it means do cross it, right? So I went to the Urban Dictionary, man. I looked up toxic masculinity. Here's the definition straight off of the internet, which the Urban Dictionary to me is an authoritative reference. Because, dude, they collect information from all these other dictionaries, man, and they use it in the most commonly used terminology and how it's applicable. So here it says for toxic masculinity, a social science term that describes narrow repressive type of ideas about the male gender role that defines masculinity as exaggerated masculine traits like being violent, unemotional, sexually aggressive, and so forth. Also suggests that men who act too emotional or maybe aren't violent enough or don't do all the things that real men do can get their man card taken. And it goes on to say, guys, many people confuse the difference between masculinity and toxic masculinity. However, one can be masculine without having toxic masculinity, right? And then here, some beliefs of toxic masculinity. I'm going to debunk each of these for you guys, because here's the problem. And I had to make this video because our society as a whole attacks young boys and young men and little boys because you don't have a point of reference or life experiences to know when you're being attacked and picked on and manipulated and persuaded, right? You don't know because you're young and you got a boner. I got it. But the problem is when they make you embarrassed for having a boner and for being an aggressive little boy, you grow up with self-esteem issues. You grow up with self-identity issues. You grow up with gender identification issues. And that's why you got a lot of these dudes, man. And I'm not going to go into a whole rant about Bruce Jenner, bro. He's just a sick fuck. But you have a lot of young boys, man, choosing to be identified as the gender as non, you know, as neutral, like non-gender, right? Because they're confused, man, because as they're going through school, like, you take a little young boy, man, it starts from, like, two up. And I can look at my little grandson. I got a little grandson, man. And I can already see some male traits, and it's just the way it is with testosterone and having testes, dude. It's just the way we're made. And so, just little boys are aggressive, dudes. Just, they got all this testosterone running around. Estrogen makes girls more sensitive and caring and compassionate and more cohesively, like, inherent in their nature. So, I'm going to share this, guys, with you, man. I have anger issues, man. I have agoraphobia, man. I'm aggressive, dude. I got antisocial behavior. I'm actually like a sociopath, psychopath. That's why I can relate to dudes like Ted Bundy, man, and Hannibal Lecter, and the guy who shot up the schools and stuff. Because I'm not saying it's right. That is not what I'm saying. I want you to understand something: is that I'm man enough and human enough to look at the fact that all of us have duplicitous behavior, dude, all of us. So when you first meet a person, I don't give a fuck if it's a man or a woman or a fucking in-law or whatever the fuck. Most people in polite American or Western society, they got a social face. They put their best face forward, man. They always want to come off as being nice and socially correct and all this stuff. And I'm not going to debate it whether it's right or wrong. Me, just like OG Sarge Tony Crawford, you get what you see, man. Like, when you meet me, I am who I am, and I don't change for anybody. Now, I'm not going to lie to you. If I need to get a contract from a big IT organization, you know, I'm going to play the polished role, sophisticated. I'm going to tone down my masculinity and my bass in my voice and be like, "Hey, good morning, guys. How are you today?" Right? I'll actually talk like that to get the money, you know? And I'll put spectacles on my gorilla beat up BJJ MMA face, right? Street fighting face. I'll put spectacles on, you know, and I'll dress up in a suit. And I won't be as aggressive in my stature or in my cadence when I'm walking, right? But, I mean, this is survival. Like, I've learned how to get along in society. And I was having a talk with my baby daughter. I was explaining to her that in this world, man, you have to learn how to play specific roles to get what you want out of life. Because if you're just yourself, not all people are going to accept you. I mean, well, I think it's fine to be yourself. You got to understand one thing. When you're trying to get money, which money allows you to live your life, then you got to play a fucking role. We're all actors or actresses. We all got to play a role to get money. So that's what I do. But in my personal life, dude, I just am who I am. I meet people. I don't give a fuck what they think or why they think it. I don't even give a fuck. I don't care what they think, because I'm just going to do what I want to do, because nobody's opinion of me is higher than mine. I'm the final authority on how I view myself. And so the problem is, like, young boys growing up, man, they're trying to fit into some kind of idealized society where we're transgender, we're trans-neutral, men and women are equal. Dude, it's fucking them up, because they don't have the historical reference to understand. Like, I'm a child of the 60s, so I seen what it was like to be a manly man growing up. I seen it what it was like when the dynamics of, I'm not trying to get religious with you guys, but the dynamics of any holy book you read, whether it's the Quran, the Bible, or whether it's the Christian Bible, the Jewish Bible, the Catholic Bible, the Book of Confucianism, even the Indian, I think it's called the Mahabharata. But what it says is, dude, it's just a fucking hierarchy of the man as the head of the household, and the woman is submissive to the man, and the woman is head over the children. Why is that? Because in the evolution of human beings, guys, back when we had tribes and we had little communities, dude, man, watch any kind of the movies I watch, like whether it's Game of Thrones, Vikings, the fucking Last Kingdom, I don't give a fuck, all the king's men, dude. You would have hordes of invaders, man, and then fucking barbarians just riding through little communities, man, or little tribes of people, and just fucking overrunning them. So who protected the tribes? Who protected the women who, don't get me wrong, there's some beast mode women. Don't get me wrong. I'm not saying that. But when a woman is pregnant, which you got to understand, men don't get pregnant. When a woman is pregnant, she's in a vulnerable state just because not only does the baby drain half of her energy and her resources, but also she's got to be protective of the baby. You know what I mean? Because somebody punches her in the stomach or stabs her in the stomach, it's going to kill the baby. Her primary role is to procreate. So during the 9-month gestation period, she can't run and jump and fight and climb trees and all this crazy shit like men can do. Maybe she can when she's not pregnant, but the fact of the matter is when she's pregnant, carrying your seed, and then you got little dudes and little girls that are your seed for the future, your job is to maintain, is to ensure that your seed grows up strong and resilient. Then when the fucking invading hordes of marauders come through, it was the man who fucking strapped up and handled this shit. You had to be aggressive. You had to be ready to kill for what you believe for. You had to be masculine. You had to be a leader. You had to have aggro tendencies. Or you wouldn't, you and your seed would not survive. So then as we evolved through the years, you know, I remember back in the 60s where the men went to work and the women stayed home and the man was the head of the household. Now, I understand there's some men that took that shit too far and they were fucking ogres and shit and fucking tyrants and dictators in their own little kingdoms. I got that. But then when they did the Women's Feminism Act and Equal Opportunity, you know, women had a lot of fucking vengeance, man. You know, they had a lot of what's it called? They wanted to revenge, bro. So they overcompensated. So instead of being 50-50, like I shared with you in many of my videos, they wanted to get payback for all the decades of unfair treatment that they suffered through, some of them. So I got it. But then when does the shit stop, dude? How long do you go before you finally go, okay, you know, I got my get back? They don't stop. So then what they do is they attack these young boys and they make them feel like it's wrong to be a boy, it's wrong to be a man, so they grow up wanting to be a girl. So here, let me get back to this Urban Dictionary of Toxic Masculinity. I'm going to debunk each of these, right? So here it says, some beliefs of toxic masculinity is that the first one is interactions between men and women always has to be competitive and not cooperative. You fucking Skippy. And let's get something straight, man, with this feminism dude, this fucking gynocentrism dude, this fucking mal-bashing bullshit. What women try to do, man, women don't play fair. What they do is they come in like, oh, you know, let's cooperate and, you know, let's work together. But all the time they have an agenda, dude, of fucking dominating your bitch ass. Because if you're not man enough to understand the fucking dynamics between men and women, dude, a woman will always challenge you, dude. That's why women always have shit tests. That's why they always fucking run in their mouth. They always got fucking smart remarks because they want to, and they don't, look here, guys, they don't even know they're fucking doing it. That's what I want you to understand something, man. When you come to my fucking channel, understand something, dude. I spent decades of my life studying fucking psychology and female psychology specifically, because first I want to understand myself, like, hey, OG Silverback, why are you so violent? Why you always want to rip men's faces off? Why you always want to rip men's heads off and shit and piss down their neck? And it wasn't until I went through decades of counseling that the counselors explained to me that growing up back east in a violent environment, when a guy talks shit to you, you know what's going to happen afterwards, right? So I react with violence because I'm already knowing the violence is going to come. So I immediately react. I'm like, I'm not going to be a passive victim. You understand? I'm going to be the fucking catalyst, right? I'm not saying it's right or wrong. I'm just saying that our experience in life shaped our personality. But here's what you got to understand when it comes to women, dude. I don't care if it's a fat woman or a short woman or a chubby woman or a hot woman or a fit woman or a masculine looking woman. A woman's imperative is to test your masculinity, is to test boundaries. That's just how it is, man. And women even test each other. You, like, if you guys don't believe me, Google this thing called the beehive syndrome, man. There's always got to be a queen bee in any group of women, and she runs shit. And so this is what I always tell you guys to be a leader. You don't have to be a leader of men. You just got to be a leader. What does that mean? Well, anytime you're dealing with a woman, you have to lead her. Because if you don't, she's not going to respect your bitch ass. And then she's going to lead you. When she gets... Women are like cats, man. Once she gets tired of fucking playing with you because you're a bitch, she's going to dump your ass. Or she'll just use you to be a fucking orbiter friend zone. Not even get to smell some pussy. You just be a little bitch boy. And she'll just be calling you up whenever she needs shit done because Biff won't do it. Or fucking... You know, any whatever other masculine names you can think of, Todd, or fucking with Jeff, any other masculine name you can think of, because dudes be like, get the fuck out of here, do it yourself, right? So that's the first one, man. They want to turn men from being masculine into making you like a feminine fucking tampon douchebag, where you just, oh, where you got to be cooperative with women. Fuck that. Here's the next one. Men can never truly understand women, and that men and women can never be just friends. That's why I got a channel, guys, because in the reality of it is, you're not going to really ever understand fucking women. Like, you don't even understand your fucking mom, dude, or your fucking grandma, right? Or your aunt, or your sister, or your cousin, because, dude, women are wired fucking differently, dude. If you don't understand that, either A, you're a dumb fuck, B, you're a stupid fuck, C, you're a fucking retard, or D, you don't spend enough time around women, because, dude, if you got any kind of a job where you're interacting with the public, dude, or you're working in an office with these HR fucking rules and fucking politics, are you dealing with women, even whether it's your siblings or your fucking, what's it called, your family members, bro? Women are different. Here, I'll give you a really interesting dichotomy. So there's a new trend, man, that's called yoga pants, man, or fucking workout pants or whatever you want to. It's like these fucking tight ass fucking leotards, man. I'm gonna call them yoga pants. I think you guys can all agree with that. But a lot of women purposely like don't wear underwear under there. They wear a thong, and you can see their fucking camel toe, right? Now I'm gonna give you an example, dude. Like, I'm nicely endowed, dude. Like, I don't have a fucking circus freak fucking cock or a fucking monstrous cock. But I got a cock. When a woman sees it, she's like, "Wow, that's nice." Like, I've always heard that, wow, that's nice, you know. And some women say it's too big, but that's not true, because being in prison, military, I've seen some dudes with some, like, deformed fucking cocks, dude. Like, I've actually seen dudes with their fucking cocks go down to their fucking knees, and it's fucking thick as my fucking forearm. I'm like, dude, that's fucking retarded, man. You know what I mean? But I got some nice-sized package, right? So the point I'm making is, back in the day, they used to have these things called Speedos, dude. We were Speedos, and they had these things called biker shorts. See, you young dudes don't know nothing about the fashion trends that, you know, I'm not saying I follow all the fashion trends, but it's like, dude, if you got workout gear and Nike's selling some workout gear, bro, and you're buying their workout gear, so when the workout gear comes in, you just buy it. It's not you trying to follow a fashion trend, but that is what the athletic wear people are having for your gear. So I used to wear these fucking biker shorts, man. And I wouldn't have any underwear on there because I just figured the biker shorts enough, so then my fucking junk, man, is just hanging there, right? So here's the equivalent. So whether I got a fucking, what's that called, man? You know how you get a boner, it's not a full boner, but it's called, oh, a chub. Whether I have a chub, I'm just hanging naturally. You know, I got some nice size length and girth, so I got my biker shorts on, or my fucking Speedos. And then when women are talking to me, they're looking at my fucking cock. Here's a woman's philosophy.
Hey, you know, my eyes are up here, you know, and I hate when guys look at my breasts or my fucking clit or my camel fucking toe.
You gotta say to yourself, then, fuck, lady, why are you fucking dressing in such a way that that motherfucker can't help but see it? So that's like me putting on my Speedos or my biker shorts, bro. And then walking around going, hey, you know what, George? I hate when women always looking at my fucking crotch, man. Like, you know, it's very disrespectful. And I feel offended and I feel violated. Get the fuck out of here. You understand? So I want you to understand that how women dress in fucking tight-ass clothes and fucking yoga pants and fucking push-up bras and all that. But then when you notice it, you're a fucking pervert, right? Or you're fucking toxic masculinity. Watch that commercial that I put the link in there, man. That'll make you fucking cry, dude. If you grew up anything like me, where men are taught to be tough and strong but silent and aggressive and a leader and competitive, that's part of being a man. If you don't do any of that, dude, you're a little bitch, boy. You don't get respect from anybody, least of all, like your peers, your men peers, your family, or even women. That's why we got this fucking MGTOW movement, incels, and Tfls, dude. Honestly, let me help you young guys understand this, because you grew up under a fucking paradigm of fucking bullshit media and fucking videos and fucking movies and music that are teaching you to be this fucking transsexual, transgender, fucking gender neutral, more feminine type of shit. And women aren't attracted to that shit, dude. No, see, this the problem, man. Women have fucking duplicitous, like, bipolar type fucking behavior and thoughts, bro. Because on the one hand, I'm telling you the truth, bro. Look, I've been to fucking quinceañeras. I've been to sweet 16 parties. I've been to all kind of, what's that called? Baby showers, man. I've been to all kind of wedding parties, dude. Weddings and fucking wakes and shit. And where there's groups of women. Because those kind of social gatherings is mostly women. And then, you know, a few guys, like, I'm forced to go with my date or my friends with benefit or whatever in order to have sex with her regularly. If I don't, like, get social with her, she's going to cut the sex off, right? So I'm like, fuck it. I'll go to a fucking, whatever the venue is. But the point I want to make is this. It'll be so many women that get in their little cliques and groups, and I'm like the only guy sitting there. Women be like, you know, I just want a guy who respects my thoughts and he cares about me as a person, and he's a nice guy, he's a good guy, and he cares about puppies and kitty cats and flowers and all this fucking bullshit. And I sit there and tell him I want to throw up, because the girl I'm with, the reason she's with me, man, because I'm a gorilla face fucking 6'4", 270 pound beast mode motherfucker, likes to fight. I'm just fucking aggressive. I've been to combat. You know, the only reason I didn't want to go to combat, I went to combat 3 times. The only reason I didn't want to go back is because you're seeing dudes getting their legs blown off, their balls blown off, their faces blown off. And then when they come home, this isn't like Game of Thrones or fucking The Last Kingdom or Vikings, where like you got an eye missing and women think that's hot, right? Or you got your arm blown off and women think, oh, he's a warrior, I'm going to suck his fucking cock, right? No, American women are like, oh, you got your fucking legs blown off for this country, you fucking invalid, you fucking paralyzed piece of shit. You know, you shouldn't have went over there in the first place. You know, after we were fucking protecting their freedoms, right? Get the fuck out of here. So the point I'm making, that's the reason I didn't go back to combat anymore. Because I didn't want to become deformed, or, I'm sorry, disabled. And then women, like, they don't respect the fact that you're disabled because you were protecting their right to be slutty whores, right, walking around trappy, right? So I'm just saying, man, it's like, they got to get the fuck out of here. It's like mixed signals and shit, dude. But the woman that I'm there at the party with, she's with me because I'm a beast mode barbarian fucking type bad boy. Like, I don't give a fuck. But yet they all sit there and say, you know, I just want a guy who's nice and sensitive and shows his emotions. And there's this movie I want you guys to see. I think it's called, dang, man. It's a movie about this guy, the guy that played in the Mummy flicks, man. And he meets the devil, bro. And she gives him 5 wishes. And he wants to be 5 different types of guys. Than what? Oh, it's called Bedazzle. I'm going to put the link in the description. Dude, you got to watch that movie, the video, bro. Because it shows that even when you try to be the nice, sensitive guy women say they want, they don't want it. See, women are confused. They say they want one thing. But who do they go out with, dude? They go out with bad boys like me, fucking cheating, fucking lying, fucking piece of shit motherfuckers like me, because that's what they're attracted to. But then they want to turn around and call it toxic masculinity. But here's another one, right? Real men need to be strong, and showing emotion is a sign of weakness unless it's anger. That's considered okay. Dude, that's part of being a man, dude. And the problem is, young boys are growing up with their moms or a weak-ass bitch boy dad who's already feminized, bro. And they're not teaching. Dude, it's part of being a fucking man. Like, men protect. Men are hunter-gatherers, dude. That's just part of the role of being a man. But that women want to redefine it to make the playing field equal for this fucking equal rights and fucking, you know, femininity is strong, masculinity is bad, right? Get the fuck out of here, bro. Don't be confused by the bullshit. Don't be misled, homie. It's all the fucking propaganda by the Illuminati because they want to turn men into fucking sheep. Like, let me tell you something, man. You go to any religious service, dude, whether it's Christian, Jewish, Catholic, Islam, motherfucking Confucianism, motherfucking Buddhism, it's mostly women, dude. And that's why these spiritual leaders can be going up in the fucking congregation or groups of women, because, dude, women are inherently cooperative. What does that mean? Cooperative means you can be led. Men are more like, man, I'm gonna do my own fucking thing. But then it's like you learn through being with other men. Sometimes you can't do your thing by yourself, so you learn to cooperate in order to get your agenda done. But women are just more cooperative. They go along. They're followers, bro. So fuck that shit, man. Here's another one: that the idea that men can never be victims of abuse and talking about it is shameful. That's bullshit, man. Men go through a fucking lot of abuse, a lot of violence, but you ain't got to talk about it all touchy-feely with our feelings and shit. So, man, this video is getting really, really long, dude, but there's some terms I wanted you to understand, man. Like, it started with the whole Me Too movement, man. And there is no toxic masculinity. It's just women trying to turn men into fucking women, dude, so they can fucking lead them around by the nose and boss them around, dude. That's all it is. And then there's this thing, no homo, where it's like, you know, men, they saying that we can't have, like, intimate relationships with other men. When I say intimate, I don't mean, like, sexual, but intimate, like, you share feelings and stuff. It's just the nature of being a man, dude. That's, like, not what your role is, dude. So, anyway, I put some links in the fucking description for you guys, because it's just too much to cover. But I just wanted to let you know, don't be fooled by the hype and the bullshit, bro. It's all a fucking agenda, man, to make you a soft little bitch boy, dude. And then let me tell you something, man. If you ever had a girlfriend, bro. Like, one time, man, I had a girlfriend, and she's like, you know, I really like guys with beards and shit, you know. And I got a gorilla face fucking beard and shit. And I don't like guys with beards. And I was stupid enough to fucking shave my beard off. Guess what happened?
You know, it's not you, it's me, you know. But just something's changed, and you just don't excite me like you used to. And ever since then, I was like, that's the last time I'm a fucking change anything for a fucking whore that doesn't know what the fuck she wants, man.
So until next time, OG Silverback. Hey, but before I say out, I want you guys to hit each of the links in my descriptions, man, because I did a lot of research for you guys. I can't cover it all in fucking 30 minutes, homie. But if you click on the links, I guarantee you one thing, you'll have a day of enlightenment, and you'll know not to be fooled by this fucking bullshit agenda of toxic masculinity. Get the fuck out of here. Till next time, OG Silverback, out.
This is my last resort. Suffocation, no.